Good morning, everyone. Vincent Jones, otherwise known as Shadow Tear, here. And, welcome to Alan Wake. That's what we're gonna be playing this month, because I did promise you guys that's what I would play. So I'm having to do this as a video because right literally as I was getting ready to fire up the stream, my, internet connection died. And it's not on my end, it's a DNS issue somewhere with Comcast, because, yeah. So, we're gonna be starting a new game. I'll show you guys a few things here and there. I do have the text turned on so people can read if they don't want to listen, or vice versa. Turned on the subtitles because I figure that's fair for everybody. For anybody who hasn't played this before, I haven't played it, I've watched people play it, so I'm still getting used to the controls. And I do play with a controller, so yeah, that's gonna be a thing. This is a, I guess you could call it like horror survival kind of game, based on... the main character is loosely based on, like, Stephen King. He's a writer. It's a very kind of New England kind of thing, so... we'll go ahead and get started. We're going to start on normal, because... I'm not sure I can handle nightmare mode, and, well, you guys would all laugh at me forever if I picked easy, so...
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Really good opening scene.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I've been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Ow.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Three spooky, five me.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
So yeah.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
That's our intro. And now we're gonna get basic play controls. No, we don't want a reverse camera. Yeah, I know that. Okay. So check this out, guys.
I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked.
Very much a dream. And he's got all kinds of copies of his books back here. Oh, I can examine.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there. The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere.
I don't know if anybody else saw it, but yeah, collectible. So let's grab that real quick.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
What's here? There's a six pack, but I can't do anything with that. Alright, here we go.
Hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Yeah. So I'm not the best at commentating this kind of a game because I haven't really actually played it before. And, I just kinda wanted to play it. But so far, very spooky, getting kind of an intro into what the storyline of the game will be later. Pretty cool. This way. Must run faster. No way out.
Die.
Really spooky.
Die.
Yeah, that's creepy. Really, really creepy. There we go.
Follow the light. You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Yeah, so one of the mechanics in this game is if you're in a bright light like that, you'll heal up.
I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light.
Yeah, the light reconstructs stuff. Wow. Interesting, right?
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The Hitchhiker has been taken over by the Dark Presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun. Pick up.
Now you'll die.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Interesting, huh? Really? For some reason, I don't think so, because I think you're a lot more dead than I am. Nope. Not gonna happen. Jump.
I can keep this up.
Okay, time to run. Really wish he was better at cardio. God damn it, Alan. You're no cardio doing ass. Go. And in. Shit. That's not good.
Easy. Alan, wake up.
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Huh, where's here? See, the name on the bridge there was Bright Falls, and the name in the dream was Night Falls, so you know.
act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with a town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife, if you don't mind me saying. I'm Pat Maine, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Maine, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller! How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car. Come on, Slowpoke. You get the full service here. I've made all the arrangements. I drive the car. I'll even carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Yep.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes.
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Can't go that way.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
These guys will play a role later in the game, but
you put the line in the coconut. Drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your sleep.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overacre fans always did.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Creepy.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed. And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
There's a reason that she's kind of like that.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid! Damn, aren't ya? It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah. Splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see ya.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wanted off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Yeah, they're good guys. You'll find out more about them later.
Bye,
but
Mr. Wade.
Very cool.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while and see those stars winking down at you. It's pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Yep. And we're still just doing the intro stuff here, so. This game is really good for that.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey.
I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Like I said, I haven't played this before, so I'm kind of checking everything out. I've seen people play this game, and it's an amazing game. Very story-driven.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel. But these days, it was no longer open to the public.
If you paid attention to what was said in the diner, it's a clinic.
Once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Alright, let's get back up here to the cabin.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Hello? Anyone here?
Yeah, I know. I saw the generator in it.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
It's an old-ass generator. Yeah,
okay, I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
And
it
another
was a
cutscene.
Beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Sorry, taking a drink. But yeah, because this chapter is a setup, there's a bunch of cutscenes, but it gets a little less cutscene heavy, so. Let's jam on back over here.
Alice? Honey? Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Surprise!
What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Dan, Alice, you... Everyone
hey,
keeps...
Hey, hey, hey! Just hear me out! There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through. Were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming!
No! Help me!
What the hell?
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Yeah, he is kind of a douchebag. More on him later. We don't have a flashlight or anything.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
So we're gonna probably get that far and then call it here, guys.
Damn.
Well, that's no bueno.
Someone there?
Pages.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
All right, let's take a look here.
Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Yeah, so, not so familiar to anybody.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation.
Deposit required. Fair and square.
Well, that's not good.
Square.
Well, let's see here.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
If I had a flashlight, that'd be great.
To arrive! You lose!
Shit.
Such a deposit.
It's the lady! Great!
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stuckey would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
There we go.
During your trying, it's the latest incontestably proven to let you
kill
one
stone.
You can see the sun. And
yes.
Keep those cholesterol.
Right, Paul, Sheriff's Station. How may I
go?
Hello?
Never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Nice.
The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season!
Not what I wanted to do. Crap. Oh well. Question.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Another collectible.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
An interesting mechanic for the reload. If you just tap the X button, like, you insert the shells faster. Nope, not that way. Gotta go up. Can't get up there. Where are we going here? Looks like we're going around here, I guess. No, that's the river. Oh, there we go. Yeah, logging site, that's where I want to be. Hang on.
Taken. They're taken.
Taken or filled with darkness. Nice. Okay. Can't get in that way, so I'm gonna go around this way, it looks like. Okay. And into here. we got? Batteries. Batteries are always good. Well, it doesn't look like we're going this way, so I guess we're going down.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Yeah, because they just leave revolver ammo lying around places.
There was no power. It was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Manuscript page. Shotgun's cool. I can deal with shotgun. For now, I'll have to roll it back though. Let's listen to this page. Damn, I missed a page. Oh well.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Down there. Let's go grab that real quick, because it's collectible. Yeah. And I'm not seeing any other hidden things or anything out here, so it does kind of bum me out that I missed a page, but it's a thing that happens. But yeah, I was looking forward to interacting with people in live chat and stuff today, because I figured out how to do that, because I'm playing this in a window, so... There we go. But internet crapped out, so... Yeah, this is a very unique story-driven game. It's one of the reasons I chose to play, because it's kind of a horror survival kind of thing. I'm digging it. Digging a lot. I think I'm going to stop here at this... safe zone.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what?
Oh no. I can't stop here, so.
Night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. Looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
So we got, hey, there we go.
At first I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice. The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no contest. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
Well, that sucked. Oh, let's see if we can heal a bit. No, it looks like we're max health. Okay. Let's keep going. I saw another one. Okay, safe haven. Let's listen to this page.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself, and possibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Yeah. So that's a thing that happened. Okay, let's... Batteries and revolver ammo. There are some more pages.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein,
these are cool.
Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide.
Yeah. It's kind of like the Twilight Zone. But, this was a series written by Alan.
I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. Yet, I myself cannot
With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality! Poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris.
That's the danger.
Or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat in Night Springs.
But yeah, so that's a little thing for you guys. Anyways, I'm gonna end this recording here, and I'll hopefully this will restart back at that last checkpoint, and or maybe this was a checkpoint, I can't remember. But yeah, so we'll call it here. This has been the beginning of Alan Wake. I hope people have enjoyed it. Hopefully Friday's stream will be a bit, well, actually I probably won't do this one again until next Wednesday. I'll make it a weekly thing. You guys have a wonderful today, tomorrow, evening, whatever you're experiencing right now. And remember, somebody does care about you. You are important. And I'll see you guys again on Friday for either some STO or some Final Fantasy IX. Take care, guys.